Every year, thousands of zombies go without homes. And you can make the difference by adopting your zombie today at Zombie Humane Society.
He's very interesting. He's not like a normal child.
When I was feeding him bread, I looked at his collar and I saw that he was from the Zombie Humane Society. And I just thought that it would be a good idea to just take him home.
Like, we wouldn't ask for anyone else.
Yeah, he's actually really nice. I don't have to buy him gifts for Christmas. Stop. And he pretty much listens to me.
Just adopt and decide that you can do it. You gotta be ready for it.
So I just thought he was really cute.
When the military came in, I had a lot of leftover zombies.
I decided to try to talk to him.
Yeah, he likes running around.
This one's good.
Instead of chasing the ball around and actually kicking the ball, he just chased the actual players in on the other team.
Thank
you.
Well, in the 1994 pocket, please. In the 1994 zombie apocalypse, I was always interested in what drove them. So I locked a lot of them in my basement, and I studied them. And, you know, the apocalypse ended when the military came in. I had a lot of leftover zombies, and I thought, well, they like humans. They don't like to be around each other. They need a human to be with. So that's what started the Humane Society.
Okay. So how successful...
Hey. Well, we get a lot of couples who, you know, maybe they don't want to go through pregnancy or they don't want to, like, they don't want to go through the child development stage. So, hey. So, it's very successful. We get a lot of, couples who, such as, don't want to go through pregnancy or, they don't want to go through the child development stage. So, they'll get a zombie. They're very easy to maintain.
So, where did you adopt your son from?
Well, since we can't have, like, normal kids, like, guy and a girl could. We're just looking around and we saw this other couple with a zombie kid, and so we asked them where they got it, and they just said the Zombie Humane Society down the block. And so we just
chill out, bro. Come on. Calm down.
Stop.
And so we went there and we just what? Okay. Ask me a question. Can't just start off.
So, have you had any good experience?
We have had some. I mean, he's very interesting. He's not like a normal child. He has way more energy. He's way more energetic.
Yeah, he definitely is. He's really fun. Like, he's just the best. We wouldn't ask for anyone else.
Like, there's pluses. I mean, he doesn't have to take a shower since he's already a zombie. He's always ready to eat. He's always ready just to go run around and chase stuff.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he likes running around.
Stop.
Stop. Hey.
Okay. We're gonna have to chain you up, Chainsaw.
Have you tried any sports?
Yeah, he tried soccer. But
like, one time during his first game, instead of chasing the chasing the ball around and actually kicking the ball. He just chased the actual players in on the other team.
Yeah, it wasn't good. They didn't. That's he can't really do sports. He likes chasing all the other kids around, so that's not good.
Yeah, we gotta keep him.
Hey, no, stop.
So,
calm down.
Would you recommend getting a zombie from something else?
Yeah.
Well, if they can't have like a generic kid, like we couldn't, then I would suggest getting a zombie.
You gotta be smart about it. You gotta be smart. You gotta know what to do. You can't just come in into the Zombie Humane Society and just adopt and decide that you can do it. You gotta be ready for it. You gotta be serious.
You gotta pick what gender you want too, because there's big differences. Like, girls just like to sleep and pretty much just lays around and eat, but the guys are more energetic and are ready to do stuff.
Yeah.
So.